Hello, my name is Tibu Vincent, teaching commerce at St. Peter Clever High School. Hope you are fine and staying home safely. I urge you to continue staying home safely and following us through the online program. Today, I would like to discuss about international trade. By definition, international trade is trade involving two or more countries. For example, this trade can take place between Tanzania and Kenya, or Tanzania with many other countries. If this kind of trade involves only two countries, it is referred to as bilateral trade. But if this trade involves more than two countries, that means many countries are trading. For example, Tanzania trading with Kenya, with Uganda, with China, and other countries. This one is called multilateral trade. Take note of that. From that, I would like also to discuss about the reasons for international trade. Reasons for international trade, or sometimes a question may ask, why does international trade arise? That's the same thing. Reasons for international trade. There are a number of reasons why international trade is carried out. The first is that there's differences in climate. We understand that there are so many countries which have different climatic conditions. Therefore, African countries, most of them practice agriculture and sell to the countries which do not practice agriculture. For example, I've said the Arabian countries, for example, Saudi Arabia, Iran, most of them involve in oil production. Therefore, we do exchange our agricultural products, we sell them to the Arabian countries or countries which do not practice agriculture, and then we buy what we don't produce. For example, we buy oil from Arabian countries. The next reason is the difference in natural resources. Differences in natural resources. We understand that various countries have got different natural resources. For example, Tanzania is blessed with the natural resources like minerals such as gold, diamonds, and others. Therefore, the minerals are mined from Tanzania and then sold to other countries. And once we get that money, we also buy what we don't have, hence leading to the rise of international trade. Another reason or another factor which leads to the rise of international trade is about differences in skills and equipment. Developed countries have got more skills and equipment. For example, they have more experts, like doctors, engineers, compared to developing countries like Tanzania. We have very few experts, like medical doctors, and we also lack the technology. The technology is not all that good, and therefore, we do exchange, we do pay for the experts from other countries to come and work in our country, and also they obtain what they don't produce. Another reason for international trade is all about political ties. International trade activities are carried out in order to strengthen political ties, and that's why our country, Tanzania, has good relationship with other countries like Kenya, Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi, and that's because of the trading activities which take place. Next is about the law of comparative advantage. The law of comparative advantage says that a country should concentrate on the production of goods in which it has the best ability. Taking an example, our country has the best ability to produce agricultural products. Therefore, we cannot struggle produce what we cannot. We cannot struggle to produce mobile phones, and therefore the law of comparative advantage of our country, agriculture is the best activity which can be practiced, and therefore this one leads to international trade due to the fact that we do exchange our agricultural products with the other countries. The next thing we have is surplus production. Some countries produce excess goods or services. Now, once such kind of excess production has occurred in the country, in order to make use of that excess production, in order to make use of the goods, the excess goods produced, countries decide to sell to other countries. Or if at all the country produces excess services, excess services can come from different experts. There could be too many doctors in that specific country. And therefore, the country decides to sell the services to other countries which are lacking such kind of services. Generally, from what we have studied, you have to take note of the important terms which we have studied. Here we have the bilateral trade involving two countries only, but again we have multilateral trade which involves the trade among countries. There are many countries, more than two countries. We have also discussed about the reasons for international trade, which I've said that differences in climate, differences in natural resources, differences in skills and equipment, political ties, the law of comparative advantage, and surplus production. Thank you very much for following up. Next time, we shall continue the topic by looking at the differences between international trade and home trade. We all know that there is international trade, which involves many countries, and we also have home trade, which takes place within the country. Therefore, we shall have to look at the major differences. What is home trade and what is international trade? Thank you very much. Remember to like and subscribe on our YouTube.